making an amazingly delicious toffee panna cotta recipe today, and I'm partnering up with Sweet Leaf to do this because you guys know me, I'm always trying to limit the amount of sugar that we have in desserts, but still have it be really, really yummy. And this recipe is so, so easy. You just kind of dump everything together. It's almost like making jello, only you get this incredibly smooth panna cotta in the end. So I can't wait to tell you guys the recipe, so let's get started.
Okay, so I'm going to start off by bringing a cup of non-dairy milk to a boil. You can use soy milk or almond milk, whatever you like. And then this is 4 teaspoons of agar agar. Because it's a vegan recipe, I'm using this. So it's made of seaweed, but you can substitute that with a package of gelatin if you want. A thing with agar, though, is that it is really, it has a really difficult time melting. So you want to really bring it to a boil, whisk it around, make sure that all of those little flakes are melted before you proceed. So sometimes I even put a lid on it, and I keep this boiling for 2 to 3 minutes on medium heat before I let it go. So a dash of salt in there, and once I think that everything is properly melted, I actually put it through a strainer because some of the stuff you can see right now, it still hasn't really dissolved yet. So agar takes a fair amount of time to do that. To that, I'm gonna add a cup of yogurt, a non-dairy yogurt, and I chose a cup. It's basically just one container of the individual portion. I think it's a little easier to do that way. And then you're just gonna mix it, and it's gonna start off being lumpy at first, but then it'll be a lot smoother. So you can see it's like this. And it is this yogurt and the coconut milk that I'm about to add to it that's going to make this panna cotta really creamy, because the yogurt kind of makes it thicker, and then the coconut cream adds a little bit of fat into it, because if you just have agar or you just have gelatin, you're really just gonna end up with something that looks like jello. But if you add something like this in, everything gets a lot creamier. Now, time for the flavoring. And Sweet Leaf has these drops that come in all different kinds of flavors. There's fruit ones, toffee, chocolate, vanilla, which I have here. And the good thing about this is if you want your panna cotta to be a different flavor, just choose a different drop. And I am going to be putting about 3/4 of a teaspoon into this panna cotta mixture. But once again, it's going to be up to you. You want to taste it a little bit first and see if you like it sweeter, add more to it. And if you don't, add a little bit less. So there's a converter chart on their site as to how much sugar it is to how many drops. So this is a cool trick right here. After everything has been mixed in, you want to put it into a cup with a spout, because really eventually you're going to be putting it into individual molds like I'm putting into the glass jars right now. So it makes this whole process a lot easier. And then you want to take a piece of napkin, wetted, and just run it around the edges just to make sure that nothing is sticking, because eventually this will set. So you want to put it into the refrigerator, I would say for a good 4 to 5 hours, and you can kind of shake it afterward just to make sure that it's all done. But basically, that is it for that. So I decided to make a little bit of an almond brittle on the side, and that just has a little bit of sugar in it and also almonds and a little bit of salt. And I just thought that the crunchiness from that pairs really well with the creaminess of the panna cotta. So you can see how smooth and nice and set that it turned out for this panna cotta. So afterwards, you just want to break the brittle into a couple pieces and just kind of put it on top of the panna cotta, and it makes an amazing decoration. And again, once again, adds that really nice crunch. So it really elevates this dessert into something that you can serve at like dinner parties, or let's say at a barbecue. I don't know, there's probably a bunch of other things that you can serve it at. Anyways, there you guys have it, my toffee panna cotta. As usual, if you like recipes like this and want to see more of it, please hit like and subscribe, and I hope you guys give this a try. I will see you guys again next time. Bye!